name is Bernard Chirifanyanga. I'm a pastor. I come from Mutoko district.
I'm Malvin. I'm from Adziwa. I'm full-time in the ministry.
My name is Isaac Paradzai. Actually, I'm from Bohera. I'm a farmer, communal farmer.
My name is Reverend Carsten Jongwe from Bohera, and I'm pastoring a church in Mtare.
As you are aware, because of this disease, HIV, most of the children are left with no parents, and they can have challenges in getting some ox to draw the plow and tractors to do the tillage. But with these foundations of farming, it's quite helping to reach the community.
We have seen foundations for farming as a tool so that we can take even the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ into my community. And we have seen many people being, saved, many people being helped, even widows who had no hope, they now have hope.
And it's helping the community to unite. So if we are teaching them, these people are uniting from different, even from different political background. And also this program is helping people to able to feed themselves.
At first, when it was introduced, I thought, what has this to do with me as a pastor? But after I was taught, the method of farming, I took it and I practiced it. I had to implement it. And after implementing it, I was able to bring food at my table to feed my family, also to feed other people in the community.
Foundations of Farming is a very good program. It has touched my community. Now the poor is now getting some grain to bring into the church and do the giving so as to get blessed.
Firstly, this program was very, very difficult to introduce it to our community. But later, after the community have seen my harvest, they came to see what I was doing.
There is a widow in our community. She doesn't have anyone who is looking after her. No one is actually supporting her. But when this we took this method of farming into our community, we have seen God at work, because she was able also to tithe even to church after having harvested from her crop, which she did through Foundations for Farming.
There is a certain woman who is also benefiting because he's doing it mulching, using water from the borehole. So he has used this for quite a long time, and this person has asked me to, he's told me that this system is working miracles and for his crops.
My vision for my community, my heart desire, what I'm desiring, my prayer for my community is that the traditions may be broken. If you keep on holding to our traditions, change will not take place. Transformation will not take place. People will die with hunger because of holding to their traditions.
Yeah, my vision is to reach out my community with the good news of preaching the gospel.
So I pray for this country for peace so that progress can be done.
My prayer for Zimbabwe is first, most people must know God first and then get wisdom from God to in order to farm God's way, so that they can feed their families and so that they can feed the community, and so that they eradicate this poverty, they eradicate droughts, they eradicate suffering.
So this is one of my prayer points, that Zimbabwe should be a self-sufficient, a self-reliant country, so that we can do our things, benefiting from our soil, from our land. so that we can feed our families.
You know, it's actually heavy in my spirit, like, you know, as a pastor, you see in the rural areas the way we are surviving as a pastor, it's actually tough. You have some children going to school, and it's heavy on you. And you see also the community which you are serving is the same thing. The people that they are not even affording on themselves to send their children to school. So as a pastor, in such an environment, it's actually hard. But my prayer is, through what God is doing right now in my community, I really believe something will come out. There will be a transformation. That's my prayer. And I always believe that God will do it in my community. I always believe God will do it. Our nation will be the breadbasket of Africa again. That's my prayer.